Hi guys, it's Jacob Blizzard. As you know, I'm a board certified criminal law and criminal appellate specialist attorney. I practice in Texas, and today I want to talk to you guys about being careful in what you do in this process and being aware of the charlatans that are out there that may appear to be people that are trying to help you and free your loved one from prison, when in fact they're sole goal is to make money and do nothing for you. Now, this is important because what I've seen out there is that there are a lot of, quote, paralegals, advocates, criminal justice investigators, people that call themselves this. And some of them do render services that are valuable. Some of them can gather records for you. Some of them can do investigations for you into a case. But you need to understand that there are a couple of things to look out for to avoid getting taken advantage of. Okay, one of the reasons that lawyers have the state bar and the rules of professional conduct is because we're bound by those, and if we violate those rules of professional conduct, we could be sanctioned, we could be suspended, we could be disbarred for taking advantage of a client, for taking money without rendering services. And all those things could occur to an attorney. When you're out there dealing with a person who's not a licensed professional, who's just a person out there trying to help people, those people are not regulated by some board. They're not going to get arrested for taking your money and but not doing anything really, because they could always claim they did something, for one. And there's no professional agency that's going to regulate the things that they're doing to prohibit them from doing things that would be otherwise unprofessional or taking advantage of people and that kind of thing. So that's kind of the first thing to think about when you're dealing with somebody who is not a licensed professional. The other thing to think about is that these people oftentimes are not people with skills. They're people with some knowledge, perhaps from their own experiences with the criminal justice system. Much like you have writ writers in prison, you have writ writers on the outside of prison. They were in prison and they got some knowledge and skills from studying in the law library and maybe doing their own writ. And those people may be capable. They may be capable of doing it more so than you are. They may have more information and they may be able to impart some knowledge from their experiences. But you still need to be very careful because these people, again, are not regulated, and these people, their experience and education is not really something that they talk about. They just claim to be a paralegal, an advocate, an investigator, and things like that. And the experience and education is kind of ambiguous, okay? Attorneys, you can always look up their credentials. You can look it up on the State Bar website. You can look on a lot of attorneys' websites. Our websites, for example, we have all of our law schools we went to, recognitions and awards that I've received, and certifications, board certifications, and things like that. That are important considerations when you're thinking about getting someone to help you with your case. It doesn't mean that it can't be done on your own. It doesn't mean that some of these people cannot be helpful, because they can be. But I've heard many stories about people who they paid some, quote, paralegal $5,000 to help them on their case, and they really didn't do anything. That is not an uncommon story. It's a common story. I have not heard a story of, oh, I paid a paralegal $5,000 and he got my loved one out of prison. I've never heard that story. Doesn't mean that it hasn't happened, but I haven't heard it. The last thing to think about in this whole process is that claiming to be a paralegal is really not a thing that someone can claim as a separate position. Paralegals work for lawyers. They work, legal assistants work for lawyers. They don't work independently. I've even seen and heard of something called a paralegal firm. That's not a thing. That's illegal. You cannot have a paralegal firm that operates and gives legal advice and does things on behalf of people. Paralegals are not authorized by the law to represent people. Only lawyers are authorized by law to represent people in criminal proceedings. Now, the writ of habeas corpus process is different. And I don't want you to be confused by that because, you know, I've talked about putting this course together that you may be able to do to help your loved one. And that's because you don't have any financial motivation to do something bad to your loved one. You want to help them. And so we're going to give you the knowledge, the tools, experience, education that we have to be able to do those things. And then you can do it in the writ of habeas corpus process as a family member, as a friend, as a representative, without having to be a lawyer. And that's how a lot of these writ writers got started in prison, is because writ writers were wanting to be used by prisoners and they didn't want to do it themselves. They wanted their buddy to do it. And so that kind of became a thing that was adopted in the law so that prisoners could do such a thing. But that's not to say that you should just go get some random person to do it for you. Whenever you look into options for yourself, whatever those options are, make sure you look into them thoroughly. And if you engage with someone to do something for you in the writ of habeas corpus process, whether it's a lawyer, a private individual, and a so-called investigator, paralegal, whatever it may be, get your agreements with that person in writing. You're going to pay them a certain amount of money, they're going to do certain things for you, or they're going to bill you at some hourly rate or something like that, so that you understand what it is they're going to do for you. And so that's what I wanted to impart to you guys today, and I want you guys to be careful. I'm saddened when I hear about people that have gotten taken advantage of by kind of these charlatan people out there. So not to say that they all are, because there are some that do good work and help people, but you just need to be careful. Thanks for watching today, and we'll see you out there. Thanks.